forever. And Therese and Jessica.
I can't really believe that they tried to set us up to make us think that we just ran into each other at the movie theater.
Yeah, but you know, they meant well. They just wanted us to get back together. I hope they didn't go to all that trouble for nothing.
Miguel, I meant what I said before. Let's not spoil tonight by thinking about tomorrow. Tonight's magical. It's just for us.
You're right.
Damn it, I can't stand watching them together. Gotta stop her. Gotta make her leave him alone. I'm gonna go snatch her ball.
I really don't think you should do that, Kay. Not if you ever want another chance.
Len, what's wrong? Can't you sleep?
I just can't seem to get comfortable. I'm sorry I woke you, sweetie. Guess it's just all part of being pregnant.
Oh, I'm sorry. Is it your back?
It's my back and my sides, my stomach. You name it, it aches.
Well, then we'll just have to give you a back rub here, huh?
Oh, I would love that. Almost as much as I love you. What was all that about? What just happened? Who's laughing? Who are you? What have you done with little Ethan? Where did you leave me? Where am I? I was at Sheridan's cottage. I smelled Tabitha's potpourri. I heard little Ethan crying. I started toward him. I went through the door and I found myself here in this horrible apartment and in these horrible clothes. What is going on? Why is this happening? Oh, goodness. It was just a dream. I'm safe here at Sheridan's cottage. My baby is safe with me. Oh, little Ethan. Oh, God. Little Ethan! My baby! Oh, God. He's gone! Where is my baby?
Poor Beth. What a strain it must be to take care of her mother with no insurance, always having to worry about money. You know, a lot of people in Beth's position would have snapped by now.
Now, Beth, it's one of the things I've always admired about her.
It's hard to imagine that anyone doing for Beth's mother what she's done.
Well, Mrs. Wallace's well-being is Beth's number one priority. She must love her more than we can imagine.
So, what's it gonna be, you diapered old crone? Are you gonna keep quiet? Or do I have to have you put away?
All right, Beth, you win. You win. I will never threaten to tell Louise any of your secrets again. Besides, even if I don't say anything to Louise, there's plenty going on here to give you away.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Well, for starters, that Charlie horse woman, you know, she wants to keep you as her special friend. And when she finds out that you are in love with Louise, oh, she's gonna flip out. And maybe, Bethy, she's gonna kill you right after she kills Louise.
All I have to do is make sure that Charlie is never at the house the same time Louise is here.
Oh, you blonde bimbos are alike. Stupid, stupid, stupid. Letting men rule your lives. You should be more like me and Beth. We'd never let a man make a fool out of us. You want to see what I do to stupid blonde people like you?
Why are you doing this to me? What do you want? Please don't let me die.
What do you want? No! Help! Please, please stay away from me. Please just leave me alone. Please, oh, oh, oh my God, what's happening? Oh my God, I'm going in the liver, but I can't be. It's too soon. I can't be having my baby now. Oh, I can't.
Do everything I can to make you feel better.
Mm. Thank you, sweetie. I'm so sorry that I woke you up.
Don't be silly. Come on, you're carrying this baby. You're putting up with all this discomfort. It's the least that I can do.
I love you very much. You have made me the happiest woman in the world.
That was my plan.
Well, I have to admit, I was a little concerned when Teresa was asking you to help her fight Julian for custody of little Ethan. I mean, I was afraid you actually might do it.
I don't want you worrying about anything.
Well, I'm not anymore, but I was worried that you would help Teresa and that Julian would fire you, and then that would leave the baby and me with no security, not to mention health insurance.
I know, but I told you. You and the baby are more important to me than anything, including Teresa. Okay, I would never put her and little Ethan before you and our baby.
I feel much better knowing that. Sweetheart, I love you so much, and I know that you love me, and we're going to be the happy family that we always were meant to be. Oh, God, where are you, little Ethan? Oh, please, God, let me find my baby. Where can he be? Oh, dear God, what has happened to him?
Yeah. It's been really hard on Beth watching her mother fall apart.
I still can't believe that Beth hired a monkey to look after her mother.
Orangutan. Precious gets upset when you call her a monkey.
Precious has got quite the crush on you, Luis.
Yeah, she's not my type.
Surely Beth could have hired a human nurse to look after her mother. I mean, come on, a monkey? Excuse me, an orangutan?
Well, Precious is specially trained to take care of people. Anyway, all the nurses that Beth did hire quit because her mom's such a handful. Seems to me like it's the best she could do.
I had no idea things were so bad for Beth.
Yeah, they're tough. Really tough. Beth doesn't deserve it. You know, she's a really good person. She doesn't deserve all this pressure.
You're right, Luis. Beth is too good a person to have this all happening to her.
I am telling you that you are skating on thin ice. If Charlie finds out that you are using her, you know, just so you can get rid of your competition, so you can have Louise, boy, she is gonna go ballistic, Mother.
Shut up. Shut up, okay? Charlie is not gonna find out about Louise because she's never gonna meet him. So stop worrying. Precious, keep an eye on Mother. I've gotta go talk to Louise and Hank. Do you remember what I said?
My crazy daughter is a total piker compared to Charlie. She's a total whack job. Hold that thought. Charlie.
Where's Beth?
Charlie doesn't know about Louise, and she never will, so stop worrying.
Hello, Charlie. Beth's in the living room. so anxious to see you. Good. Precious. Get ready for World War III. Because Ding Dong here is gonna blow her stack when she sees Betty drooling over Louise.
You're cold, huh?
Not really.
Yeah.
I did think spring would blow up here, though.
Wear this.
No, then you'll be cold.
What's that old song? I have my love to keep me warm.
Oh, yeah.
No, seriously, I'm fine, Charity.
All right, then thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, I guess we should go home. It's getting late.
It's not that late.
Yeah, it is. And I don't want you to catch a cold without a coat on.
All right. I'll walk you home.
No, you don't have to.
Please. I want to.
They're leaving. I have to follow them.
What? Don't be ridiculous, Kay. What if Miguel sees you? He'll think you're stalking him and you'll drive him even further away.
Okay. Fine. But I want some more of that anti-love potion. I am not going to stop until I make Miguel forget about Charity and turn back to me.
Kay, you have no idea what's in store for you.
Well, go on, right in there, Charlie. No, Beth's dying to see you.
I'm dying to see her, too. Beth and I have a lot to talk about.
Luis is gonna be in big trouble when she sees him.
What are you doing, you silly ape? Get out of my way!
God, I'm still pregnant. I didn't give birth. I'm lying here. I'm safe.
No, of course you didn't have the baby. You're just having a bad dream.
Oh, it was horrible. It seemed so real.
What about?
Those clowns again.
You're dreaming about the clowns again?
Yes. They broke in here and they gassed you, so you couldn't help me. They kidnapped me and they carried me off to this pit somewhere and they threw me in it. It was just dark and eerie, and then they started throwing firecrackers at me.
That sounds horrible.
No, it got worse. I then went into labor and I had my baby, only they took it from me and they wouldn't even let me hold my own baby.
Look, I'm sorry. I can see how upset you are, but listen, I read somewhere that pregnant women, that they can have these really upsetting and disturbing dreams.
Really?
Yeah. I'm sure that's all it is. But
you're safe now. You're here with me and I'm not going to let anything happen to you. I promise.
Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you for being here for me. I love you very much.
I love you, too.
Mm. No! What is that?
I don't know.
Who is that?
No! I'm not sure, but it sounds like Teresa. Gwen, my God, she's at Sheridan's cottage. Maybe whoever tried to kill Sheridan has come back. I gotta get back down there.
Well, I don't want you going there by yourself. I'm gonna come with you. Where is my baby? I can't find him. My baby. No! No!
know my baby. He's gone.
What?
What do you mean he's gone?
He's gone.
Crib is empty, but he has to be here somewhere.
No, I looked everywhere.
Where could he be?
I don't know.
Look, Teresa, did you see anybody come in? Did you see anything unusual happen?
No, I was having this terrible nightmare, and in my dream, little Ethan was missing, and I woke up, and he's gone.
What is going on? We heard a scream. It
sounded like you, Teresa. Is everything okay?
Little Ethan, he's missing.
What? What do you mean, missing?
He's gone.
Wait, I don't understand. Where could he be? What do you mean? Was he kidnapped, or did Julian have someone take him away?
I don't know.
Look, he's a very active baby. Maybe he just crawled away. Have you looked everywhere?
No, I've looked everywhere that I can think of, but he was in the crib, and he doesn't even know how to get out of the crib yet.
You know what? Somehow he figured how to get out. I mean, that's...
That must be it. All right, he probably just crawled out of his crib. Now let's just keep looking. I don't know. He must be around here somewhere.
Get out of my way. That damn orangutan is gonna spoil my plan.
Beth, I'm so sorry it's been so difficult for you to take care of your mom.
Thanks, Hank.
I really admire you for how strong you've been. I don't think most people could handle this.
Yeah, me too. I just wish all our friends could get their lives back on track. I wish you and Sheridan could tell Antonio once and for all that you two have been in love all this time.
I know how hard this has been for you, Luis, not being able to tell Antonio the truth, and you've been trying for so long.
It's just that every time we try and tell him, something happens. Or Sheridan gets so upset.
It's because she hasn't wanted to hurt him. But at this rate, he'll never know. Antonio could go on forever thinking that he's the only man in Sheridan's
life. That's not gonna happen. Now that Sheridan's pregnant, I'm not gonna let this charade go on. Now, whether the baby is mine or not, I will help raise him, and Antonio will know the truth.
But how, if Sheridan keeps finding excuses not to tell him?
So I'll tell him. Tell him with or without Sheridan.
I am telling you, get away from that door and let me pass. What's gotten into this silly monkey? Why won't you let me pass?
I don't know.
Quisiera olvidarte, dejar de soñar que tú fuiste mi amante, mi cielo y mar. Si te pudiera ver una vez más.
Look at her. She's getting all red in the face. What the heck has gotten into her?
I think you have to take the bull by the horns, Luis. Sheridan's too soft-hearted. She doesn't want to hurt Antonio.
Neither one of us wants to hurt him, all right? But Antonio has got to be told, and I think that the baby that Sheridan's carrying is mine. I'm not going to let another man, not even my own brother, raise my child. All right, I'm going to be there for that baby and for Sheridan, no matter what.
Poor Antonio is going to be devastated, Luis.
And I'm sorry for that. I don't want to see my brother unhappy, but I'm not going to let another man raise my child, period.
I hear what you're saying. I understand completely. I just hope we find the person that's trying to hurt Sheridan.
Oh, I'll find him. If anyone tries to hurt Sheridan again, I'm going to hunt him down and make him pay for the rest of their life.
It's all my fault. I never should have taken my eyes off the leaping.
Don't be ridiculous, sis. Look, you gotta sleep sometime, okay?
If anything has happened to him, I'll never forgive myself.
Here he is.
Oh, you found him out.
Thank goodness.
Oh, my precious baby.
It's okay.
Mommy is so, so sorry. Mom will never, ever let you out of her sight again. You hear me?
Thank goodness no one took him.
Oh, you scared me to death. You know that? Don't ever scare Mommy like that again. Thanks, Ethan. Thank you for finding my baby.
It's okay.
Oh, yes. I know. Everything is so good. Everything is so good now, isn't it?
My God. What's wrong with this stuff? It's hard as a rock.
The potion hardens when it gets cold. It only works when it's nice and warm.
Okay, well then let's throw a fire into this baby right now.
Don't turn the heat up too high, dear. It has to come to a simmering boil slowly.
Yeah, whatever. I just need it to be hot ASAP.
Hey, you're not listening. Turn the heat down. This potion cannot be heated quickly.
Well, why not, Tabitha?
Because it's a highly flammable liquid and it'll explode if you're not careful. Into disaster as usual.
Well, who makes potions that blow up in your face, Tabitha?
A witch. That's who. And who turns the heat up high under a flammable liquid when they've been warned specifically not to do so? An idiot. That's who.
Hey, watch who you're calling an idiot, Tabitha, unless you want the entire town of Harmony to know you're a witch.
I thought you wanted to be a witch, too.
No. What I want is Miguel, and I am willing to do whatever it takes to get him. Now get busy and make me another anti-love potion right now, because I need to tear Charity and Miguel apart, and fast.
Cheeky girl.
Oh. How can I ever thank you, Ethan, for finding my baby?
Just glad he's all right.
If anything ever happened to him, I'd die. I mean, he's all I got left.
Teresa, that's not true.
Yeah, Ethan's right, Teresa. You've got us, your family.
Oh, I know, and I'm so grateful. I just meant...
Yeah, we know what you meant, Teresa.
Hey, Gwen, Sheridan's... She's had a rough night, too. Why don't you take her back in the bedroom there? I'll be in a second.
Of course. Hey, is everything okay? And you are as pale as a ghost.
I guess so, Gwen. Thanks.
Antonio said you had a rough night.
I had a horrible nightmare.
You all right now?
I suppose.
Quinn, I don't know why, but I have this horrible feeling in the pit of my stomach that
Something horrible is going to happen in Harmony very soon.
Thanks for coming down, Ethan. Helping to look for little Ethan. We really appreciate it.
I wouldn't be able to live with myself if I let anything happen to my namesake. I'm just glad the little guy didn't crawl away too far.
Well, I guess I'll go check on Sheridan. You don't mind locking up after Ethan and Gwen leave, do you?
No.
I'll make sure everything's locked up tight.
I appreciate it. Good night, sis.
Good night.
Well, I guess it's time for a toddler bed, huh? Since little Ethan can't be contained in his crib anymore.
How do you know about toddler beds?
You kidding me? I'm gonna be a father soon. I read up on these things.
Well, I'm sure I would have heard little Ethan climbing out of his crib if I wasn't having that horrible nightmare.
What was that about?
It was awful. I was in this broken down apartment. I was dressed in rags and I couldn't find little Ethan. And then there was this television and on it was an episode of The Boosebornes.
Isn't that wacky, dysfunctional family?
Yeah. Julian and Rebecca were the stars.
Well, that would definitely qualify as a nightmare.
And not only that, but little Ethan was a teenager on the show, and he didn't even know who I was. Julian and Rebecca had raised him to be a holy terror. See, I know that it was a sign sent from God to never let Julian get his hands on my son. He would destroy my precious baby. I just know it.
Teresa, it's just a dream.
But it could happen, Ethan. You gotta help me. You gotta help me to make sure Julian never gets custody of little Ethan. You have to.
You and the baby are more important to me than anything, including Teresa. Okay, I would never put her and little Ethan before you and our baby.
I feel much better knowing that. Sweetheart, I love you so much, and I know that you love me, and we're going to be the happy family that we always were meant to be.
Please, Ethan, you have to help me. You have to help me fight Julian.
Well, I came to get your advice on how to handle the situation with Antonio, but I can see that you've got your hands full with your mother.
Pretty quiet right now, but seems like you've already made up your mind to tell Antonio with or without Sheridan.
Yeah, but I know I'm not the most diplomatic guy in the world, and well, I think you can help me figure out a way to tell Antonio the truth without causing him a lot of pain.
Well, I'd be happy to try.
I'm sure you'll find a way, Beth. Look how well you handle your mother. That takes a lot of courage and a lot of heart.
I agree.
Why don't I go make some coffee and then we could talk?
Actually, I want to get back to Sheridan's right now just to make sure she's okay.
Of course.
I'll take a rain check, though, okay?
Okay.
I'll come along, Louise. Good night, Beth.
Good night.
Night. Always share it in. Not for much longer.
I hear voices. Who's Beth talking to, Mrs. Wallace?
Voices? Gee, I don't know. Why don't you go in there and find out?
Get past this Simeon. Precious, come on. I thought we were friends. What's the matter? Are you hungry? How about a delicious banana. Come on. Come again. Come on, baby. Come on. Here we go. Here we go.
Beth? Who was just here? I know I heard voices. Who was it?
Some of these ingredients, but not all. I'll have to dig up some more pigweed. 3 quills of a porcupine.
Are you kidding me? Tabitha, why don't you have this stuff laying around?
Have it laying around?
Yeah, don't you have like a witch's pantry or something where you keep all these strange ingredients handy?
Of course I do, Kay. But most of these ingredients have to be fresh or they won't work.
Yeah, okay. So how long is this going to take?
If I use the microwave version, about a year.
A year?
And if I use the conventional stovetop recipe, I'd say about 10 years.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Tabitha, it didn't take you 10 years to make this junk that just blew up all over us.
No, of course it didn't. Because I already had the starter mix, which you have just destroyed. Thank you very much.
I can't wait a year. Charity and Miguel will be married by then.
Well, then, you'll just have to use your feminine wiles, won't you, dear?
Please, you can't say no. You know what would happen if Julian would erase my baby. It would destroy him. You know that.
I certainly agree that little Ethan belongs with you, all right? Not with Julian. There's no question about that, Teresa.
Well, I'm glad that you agree, but that's not going to do me much good in a court of law if I'm fighting Julian. I need a lawyer, a good lawyer, and you are the best one I know. And I need a friend, Ethan. I need a friend on my side, someone who will fight for my rights as a mother. Please, tell me that you will help me. Tell me that you will help me fight Julian. If you don't, I will lose my baby. I know I will.
Oh. All right. I will help you fight for custody of little Ethan.
Oh, you will. I knew I could count on you.
You can count on me.
Don't lie to me, Beth. Somebody was here. Who was it? Who were you talking to?
I told you Charlie wouldn't be happy about your hunka burning love.
Charlie, I was, talking to the police. Here, come in. It's chilly out there.
The police? Why? What do they want? They're not onto us, are they?
No. Don't worry about that.
Then what do they want?
They said that they got a call about a stranger in the neighborhood or something, and they're just going door to door, making sure that we haven't seen anyone suspicious. Charlie does not look suspicious, okay?
Hello? Have you lost your contact lenses or something? Look at the woman. At least she thinks she's a woman.
Okay. Come on, girlfriend. We got a lot of work to do.
This wind is really cold. It's odd. It's kind of weird, don't you think?
A lot of weird things going on lately, Hank. Ooh, wind does chill to the bone. Just can't get rid of the feeling that something's gonna happen. Something bad.
You okay now?
I don't know. I just have such a horrible feeling from that nightmare.
Try not to think about it, okay?
It's been a weird night anyway. You know, your nightmare, little Ethan getting out of his crib like that.
Yeah, thank God he was all right.
Yeah, thank goodness. What about your nightmare? That's all it was, Sharon. It was just a bad dream.
It seems so real to me.
I know it does. But look, those clowns, they're just in your mind. They're just part of a bad dream, and that's it. I'm here now, and I'm going to take care of you. You can be safe with me.